Making headlines tonight, Pollard urges Hetmyer to work harder. Antigua and Barbuda boxer set to put best foot forward. And Mickelson surprises at PGA Championship. Good evening and welcome to the Major ZDK Sports Edition for Friday, May 21, 2021. I am your presenter, Terry Laraji. Now for the details. We begin tonight bowling off with cricket. West Indies white ball captain Kyron Pollard says he wants to see Shimron Hetmyer competing in all three formats for the men in maroon, but believes the Guyanese batsman has to work harder if he wants to regain a Cricket West Indies central contract. Speaking openly on Hetmyer's career and a number of other topics, Pollard reasoned that the 24-year-old player will only excel if he is hungry enough for success. In 16 tests, Hetmyer averages 27.93 and is yet to register a century. But in one-day internationals, he has 500s and averages 36.6 from 42 innings, while in T20 internationals, he has scored 379 runs with a strike rate of 116.9. However, over the last year, he has scored 100 runs from 5 innings in T20 internationals and just 14 runs in 2 one-day internationals. In terms of the upcoming white ball series against South Africa, where the Windies will play 5 T20s in Grenada, Pollard warned that the side who is rated at number 10 in the T20s must be on top of their game. Today, after all testing negative for COVID on two occasions, the West Indies men have commenced training at their camp in St. Lucia ahead of the South Africa series. After a light session yesterday afternoon, the 30-man squad had a 2-kilometre run this morning in the build-up to the first test, which bowls off on June 10. Meantime, former West Indies fast bowler turned analyst Richard Prof Edwards believes veteran batsman Christopher Henry Gale could still add plenty of value as an X-factor, with the team set to continue preparations for the upcoming T20 World Cup. The big-hitting left-hander was included in the 18-man squad for a flurry of upcoming T20 matches in the Caribbean against South Africa, Australia and Pakistan. The 41-year-old batsman's inclusion, along with the inclusion of a few other senior players, has continued to divide opinion. While some believe the players are solid and experienced additions to any potential World Cup squad, there are others who believe the focus should be on developing younger players. Edwards, however, believes a player like Gale's ability to change a game means he should very much remain a consideration despite other potential drawbacks. Meanwhile, with a very packed summer of cricket coming up around the region, as South Africa, Australia and Pakistan embark on our shores, fans are eagerly asking about how they view the action of an improved Windies outfit in what promises to be some very hot contests. Speaking recently on Sportsline, CWI Commercial and Marketing Director Dominic Warne explained that free-to-air is always important and therefore Flow Sports will have a highlights package of each match.
Free-to-air is always important because it's how you get to the majority of people. And the agreement that we've done in the Caribbean with Flow Sports means that Flow are distributing a 45-minute highlights package to all of the free-to-air channels around the Caribbean. So it means sure that after a West Indies game, people can actually see a full highlights package. Of course, you can follow those online as well. Free-to-air will always continue to be important, not just for TV, but for obviously for radio as well.
According to Warne, to improve investment in the sport, rights are sold to cable television companies to create revenue.
One of the big issues is, in terms of sport, is generally that professional sport, more and more money is invested into it to improve facilities, to improve performance, equipment, and that investment requires revenue. And generally, the only way to get that, or certainly has been for the last 20 years, is through cable TV. That's exactly the same in the States, exactly the same in Europe and Asia. And I think it's always about finding the right balance of getting the right revenue so that you can sustain yourself and continue to invest, but equally making sure you've got the right, you know, getting to as many people as you can that the broadcast allows you to.
Dominic Warne. All series involving the West Indies can be viewed live on Flow Sports, ESPN Caribbean, BT Sports UK, Super Sports Africa, Sky Sports New Zealand, and live ball-by-ball radio coverage, courtesy of Vibes FM, Dominica. Meantime, the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots have announced their intentions for the 2021 Hero Caribbean Premier League CPL, which takes place in St. Kitts and Nevis from August 28 to September 19. The Patriots have brought in two players from other franchises. They have signed DJ Bravo from Trinbago Knight Riders in a trade deal that saw Dennis Ramden go the other way. And they've also signed Shafane Rutherford from Guyana Amazon Warriors. In addition to these two signings, they have retained Evan Lewis, Fabian Allen, Sheldon Cottrell, John Ross Jagasar, and Red Emirate, with exciting young prospects Joshua Da Silva and Dominic Drakes rounding out the retentions. The Patriots have 8 spots to fill to complete their squad, and these will be announced in the coming weeks. And the Board of Control for Cricket in India, BCCI, has put in a late request to the England and Wales Cricket Board, ECB, to bring forward the start and the end of the 5-test series by a week in a bid to complete the pandemic-interrupted 2021 Indian Premier League IPL season. According to ESPN Crick Info, the request was put in this week and the ECB has yet to respond. As things stand, the first test is scheduled to begin on August 4 and the series to end on September 14. The move is aimed at having a longer window in September to finish the remainder of the IPL season, which was suspended midway due to a growing number of COVID-19 cases among players and staff. In other sporting developments tonight, serving into tennis, the game of tennis continues to grow here in Antigua and Barbuda. This is according to Antigua and Barbuda Tennis Association General Secretary Peter Quinn, who noted on Sportsline yesterday that we are seeing both male and female players, especially around the age of 14, coming through the ranks as they look to emulate Antigua and Barbuda's top player, Jody McGinley.
We have some promising aspects in respect of the under 14 girls and boys that are just on the cusp of graduating into the under 18 category. But in respect of local talent, over the last few years, the highest ranked player who has come through our ranks is one Jody McGinley, and he was ranked as high as 509 on the ATP men's ranking in October 2019.
Peter Quinn. The Antigua and Barbuda Tennis Association has been overseeing developments on and off the court since 1975 as a not-for-profit affiliate of the International Tennis Federation, ITF, primarily focused on identifying and nurturing young talent. Meantime, Coco Gauff battled through to the second WTA final of her burgeoning career as the 17-year-old American sank the title hopes of Katerina Siniaková in Parma. At the Emilia-Romagna Open today, Gauff scored a 7-5, 1-6, 6-2 victory over the player who shocked top seed Serena Williams in round 2 of the clay court tournament. And world number 3 and 2018 champion Simona Halep has withdrawn from the French Open with a left calf injury. The Romanian, who lifted her maiden Grand Slam title at Roland Garros, had to be helped off court at the Italian Open after tearing a muscle. Halep is the 3-time finalist of the French Open, which starts on May 30. The 29-year-old won Wimbledon in 2019, so will be the defending champion if she is fit for this year's event, which begins on June 28. Stepping in the boxing ring, Antigua and Barbuda's sole Olympic boxing qualifier, Alston Ryan, is set to put his best foot forward at the Tokyo Games. Speaking on yesterday's Sportsline show, Alston's father, John Ryan, said that from early doors he realized his son has what it takes and therefore sent him to England to train with none other than Antigua and Barbuda world champion Maurice Hope.
He ranked among the best, so definitely that he's good. It was my dream some years ago because I saw the talent in him. And, so, you know, let me send him to England because we're good here. We are good coach here. But in order for getting to the top level, we need to have a lot of good sparring, good fights that we definitely cannot get in Antigua. So that's when I decided to send him to England.
According to John, Alston, in the 4 years he has been based in the UK, has made a big name for himself, including being reigning King of the Ring champion.
Which is a mode of achievement since he's in England. Professional gym would welcome him to train. So Alston's been training all the time since. Then champ right now. He's the 2-time Box Cup champion and is also the King of the Ring champion.
The plan moving forward is for Alston to turn pro shortly after the Olympics as world titles beckon.
We have one more games after the Olympics, which is World Games in October, and definitely next year, pro. Well, I mean, we're looking for at least, say, a 3-division world champ so we can start a lightweight and a step up. That's what we planned for the pro. Definitely. It's been a long time. That's why I always know from way back when he was going to make it to the Olympics. I always believe it. And I keep on saying it.
John Ryan. Alston Ryan qualified for the upcoming Olympics as he is ranked 5 in the Americas and will contest the lightweight division. Today it was announced this summer's Olympics will go ahead, even if Tokyo remains in a state of emergency, says International Olympic Committee IOC Vice President John Coates. Japan's capital is one of 9 prefectures under a state of emergency until May 31 at the earliest because of the coronavirus pandemic. It was brought in because of a rise in cases, which has since started to fall. Recent polls, however, in Japan have shown nearly 70% of the population do not want the Olympics, which starts on July 23, to go ahead. Meantime, Deontay Wilder will not step aside to allow Tyson Fury to fight Anthony Joshua in August, Fury's US promoter Bob Arum has stated. The 32-year-old Fury agreed to face the 31-year-old Joshua in Saudi Arabia. But Wilder's team forced an arbitration hearing, which concluded he had a contractual right to face Fury for a third time. The latest fight is set to take place in Las Vegas on July 24. With Fury now set to fight Wilder, Joshua's promoter Eddie Hearn says he has had to switch to Plan B, which could mean facing the WBO mandatory Alexander Usyk. Kicking into football, after a 14-month hiatus, football resumes in the land of wood and water. With the Jamaica Premier League set to kick off spectator-free on Saturday, June 26, with the finals scheduled for Sunday, September 26. Chairman of the Professional Footballers Association of Jamaica, Chris Williams, made the announcement during a Zoom press conference, and which was attended by the main stakeholders, including Jamaica Football Federation, JFF President Michael Ricketts. Williams revealed that a total of 66 matches are expected to be played during the preliminary round of the competition, where each of the 12 teams will play each other once. Meantime, manager Nuno Espirito Santo will leave Wolves at the end of the season by mutual agreement. The 47-year-old Portuguese, who left Porto to take charge in 2017, won the championship title in his first season. Wolves finished 7th in the Premier League in the past 2 seasons. In September, Nuno signed a 3-year contract extension to 2023. Wolves are 12th, heading into the final game of the season at home to Manchester United on Sunday. Shooting the basketball in the NBA last night, the Washington Wizards eased to a 142-115 win over the Indiana Pacers to book their place in the NBA playoffs. The Wizards had lost 118-100 to the Boston Celtics in their first Eastern Conference play-in contest on Tuesday. But Bradley Beal scored 25 points on Thursday as Washington took their last chance to reach the postseason. The Wizards secured the 8th seed in the conference and faced the top-seeded Philadelphia 76ers in the first round of the playoffs, beginning on Sunday. Running into athletics, the blockbuster women's 100-meter clash scheduled for this Sunday at the Moolah Grand Prix Diamond League meet in the UK will feature 3 of the 6 fastest women ever to run over the distance. In what many predict could be a preview to the Olympic Games later this summer, Jamaican speed queens Shalyan Fraser-Pryce and Elaine Thompson-Arrah will finally face red-hot American Sha'Carri Richardson, the early season favorite, for the first time this year. Historically, as far as the speed record book is concerned, the early season clash could be one of mammoth proportions. The trio are not only 3 of the 6 fastest women alive, but also the only ones still active on the all-time speed list. Fraser-Pryce holds the 4th fastest time ever recorded over the distance at 10.7, set in Jamaica in 2012, while her compatriot, Thomas Arrah, matched that time at the same venue in 2016. Richardson has now joined the exclusive list last month with her clocking of 10.72, recorded in Florida, making her the 6th fastest of all time. Swing into golf, if you thought Phil Mickelson was done as a major contender, think again. After 5 birdies over the last 8 holes of his second round, he claimed the clubhouse lead at the PGA Championship. The 50-year-old Mickelson may have had an anxious eye on the cut line when after an early birdie at the 11th, he bogeyed 13, 17 and 18 to slip back to level par for the tournament and needing a solid front nine to halt the slide. Instead, he roared back up the leaderboard with some vintage golf, reviving his unlikely challenge. Mickelson finished on 5-under par, two shots ahead of a group of players on 3-under, including Brooks Koepka, while Rory McIlroy is struggling to make the cut on 3-over after 3 holes of his second round today. And finally tonight on this day in history, in the year 2000, hoodoo, what hoodoo? England had only won 4 of their previous 23 tests at Lord's, but they demolished Zimbabwe by an innings and 209 runs, their biggest victory for 26 years, as the first 7-test summer in England got underway. Zimbabwe never recovered from being reduced to 8-for-3 by Andy Cuttick on the first morning, and Ed Giddins took 5-for-15 in only his second test. But within a month, though, Giddins was dropped. And that story has brought us to the end of our sporting developments for tonight. Now to recap our top story. West Indies white ball captain Kieran Pollard says he wants to see Shimron Hetmyer competing in all 3 formats for the men in maroon, but believes the Guyanese batsman has to work harder if he wants to regain a Cricket West Indies central contract. I have been your presenter, Terry Laraji. Thank you for listening. To watch ZDK Sports Package, go to the YouTube channel of Terry Laraji, The Straight Bat, and subscribe. Stay tuned now for your Voice of America update. Do enjoy the rest of your evening and have a great long weekend.